Hi, YouTubers out there. This is Fortune Cookie 45LC coming to you. And quite a few of us are going to be looking around for a good purchase of a used revolver. So suppose we go into a gun shop and look at what they have in the used counter, and we see, for example, a double action revolver like this. This is a Colt, police positive, double action revolver. It was used commonly by law enforcement and also by homeowners looking for protection, and it's still a very viable option today for a sportsman or a homeowner. I know a lot of you already realize what you're looking for when you're looking at a used revolver, but let's go over some of the things. The two great enemies of a used firearm are abuse and rust. So let's look at the finish of this, and you'll see that the finish is very good. We don't see any rust on the bottom strap, the back strap, underneath the trigger guard, or in these little crevice places like the bottom of the crane. We open it up, check for rust, and there is none. Check for rust in the barrel and in each one of the cylinders, and there isn't any. So rust is the result of neglect, which is a form of abuse. You have to ask yourself, if I were some moisture, where would I be on the firearm? And those are the areas that could get some rust. Next thing we want to check is the screws. We want to look for damaged screw heads. And if there are any, that's a sign that the previous owner did not take the care necessary to fit the screwdriver to the screw head and not mar the screws or damage them. Just simply wanting to tighten the screws up can be a source of damaging the screws if one isn't careful. Now, this particular revolver, the screws are perfect. We also want to make sure all the screws are present, because even on new revolvers, it's possible to have screws missing. Now we want to check the ejector rod to make sure it moves freely, the cylinder spins freely, and also when we spin the cylinder, you want to see if the ejector rod, whether there's a shroud or not — this particular model didn't have a shroud — that ejector rod does not make a big circle, but it's pretty concentric. We want to look at the fit of the crane to the frame. This should be a good fit. On all your revolvers, they do not put this together so that there's a big opening there. If there is, pass up on that revolver because it has been abused. Check for the fit of the stocks to the frame. There shouldn't be any gaps or openings. Should be reasonably well fitted. This one is. This revolver is in remarkably good condition for as old as it is. Next, we want to check the action. So, we've already checked to make sure it's not loaded, so we're right there in the gun store. You want to see if there's any movement in the cylinder, either fore and aft or rotational. If there isn't any, or only a very small amount, that's acceptable. check each cylinder, each chamber, because it's possible for there to be inconsistent fitting. And this one is perfect. There's very, very little movement. In fact, there's none, even fore and aft. There's just no movement in each one of the chambers. It's very impressive. Now the trick is, if you're interested, you don't want to act like you're salivating over a particular revolver. Certainly, if you find any rust or anything of that nature, you can talk to the store owner about the adjustment of the price, because you're looking at a gun that might have rust on the innards. Certainly, the action is very smooth on this particular revolver. This is a Colt Police Positive in 38 Special Caliber. Now, if you're in the market for a single action revolver, once again, you want to check for rust. You want to check the back strap, the bottom of the grip. Check for fitting. This one has custom grips on it, so you want to look for cracks in the grip condition there. You want to check to make sure all the screws are present. And they are. On single action revolvers, you want to check to make sure that the ejector rod housing is not loose. And you want to check to see if the ejector rod works without any kind of problem. And it works fine. Once again, you want to check for end shake to see if there's movement fore and aft of the cylinder. And you want to check to see if there's any movement or excessive play in a rotational manner in each chamber. Now, Ruger's will have a little bit of play, but that's okay. Check the bore to make sure there's no rust in the bore. Check the sights, because some of the single action revolvers are subject to some heavy use, and the sights could receive damage. Certainly, if there's a little bit of damage, that will require replacement of the sight blade or even the whole rear sight. It's possible. On single action revolvers, you should take the cylinder out, check each chamber to make sure we don't have any amount of rust or corrosion in the chambers, the chamber mouths, and also at the top part of the where the case goes, so that there's been good cleaning done, especially in some calibers where they might be shooting a shorter case, like 38 Special 357 Magnum. This happens to be a 45 long Colt, but people shoot shorter rounds like the 45 Schofield in these chambers, and certainly if they are shooting a lot of shorter casings, there could be some corrosion above that. We want to check to see that there's no damage around the firing pin hole, because that could be from careless cleaning. The cleaning rod goes through and actually peens this opening. Now, on revolvers, we want to check to see the firing pin protrusion in that little space there where the cartridge case head is. The firing pin should actually protrude halfway into that space. Now this is important because if the firing pin does not protrude halfway into that space, say it's less or even a lot less, you might be dealing with ignition problems, misfires caused by the firing pin not impacting enough in there. But it's not just ignition problems. If the firing pin does not protrude far enough, you could get problems with the primer. When the round goes off, the primer metal actually flows back into the firing pin hole, and that will actually tie up your next shot. You will not be able to fire the next shot. So that primer protrusion actually helps prevent that. So we need to have a strong firing pin impact for functioning. And that's true also for your double action revolver. Notice that when the firing pin comes down, does that firing pin go halfway into that opening? And if it does, you've got good specifications there. If not, you might have some problems with ignition or primer flowback. So look for that. So YouTubers out there, have a good time. Hope you can find the guns that you want. And sometimes when you're shopping, you might see something that you weren't even looking for, but turns out it's a good chance to make a purchase. This is not made anymore. And if you can find one in 95% condition like this one, where the bluing is all there from the original, there's not a lot of holster wear, and even if there's holster wear, that certainly does not mean that it's not a good shooter. It's just that it may not be as desirable for you to keep or have. If the gun's been refinished or re-blued, that actually takes away from the value of it. And if you don't have the original grips like you have here, original grips, if you have substitute grips, that makes the gun actually a little less desirable. So certainly if you have a gun like this with custom grips, you should ask the store owner whether the person that's trying to sell this gun also included the older grips or the original grips, because you want those. If those are available with the gun, certainly you want to be able to get that. You also want to ask if the Ruger revolver that you're trying to buy happened to be a convertible, because the store owner may have forgotten that there's another cylinder that comes along with this gun. And if there is, you certainly want that cylinder, so that the 45 Long Colt came with a 45 ACP cylinder. If you didn't ask about that, you buy the gun and you lost out on the extra cylinder simply because the store owner forgot that it came with the gun. So ask about that, especially in calibers that came in convertible models. This might be a convertible model, and in fact, this one is. So YouTubers, think about these things when you're out shopping for a used revolver. It's important to look at some of these things, because it'll help you get a good value. Good luck. Bye for now.